and Jeopardy. And I'm watching myself for years and years and years with my kids. Because when you're watching Wheel of Fortune, you say to yourself, how stupid is that person? And you're guessing the word ahead of time. Then you watch Jeopardy and you go, how stupid am I? How can an 18-year-old kid know all this, a 14-year-old kid know all this stuff? Because the thing about Jeopardy was it's like they have team things on in high school things. So Wheel of Fortune was created by Merv Griffin, who was a television host. He was a big band singer who took his knowledge of music, and he was a songwriter. And, you know, he sang like Frank Sinatra or Tony Bennett, but he wasn't a Frank or a Tony. He was a Merv. So he became more of a personality. He had a television show, the Merv Griffin Show. But I used to watch every afternoon right after school. I'd rush home because he had on really cool guests, and he had really good talk and chatter, and he was funny. He was a good guy. He had a guitar player in his band called Herb Ellis, who was a great guitar player. Every once in a while would get a solo. I would just sit there waiting for Herb Ellis to play a solo. So him and his wife at the time, who was Eva Gabor, you remember Zsa Zsa Gabor, the actress? Her sister was Eva Gabor. She was married to Merv Griffin. They would have a dinner party with friends and people by the pool or in the rec room and play Hangman, kind of backwards. And so they took Hangman and made it into Wheel of Fortune, where they you print out the letters. Or if you ever play Battleship, the same thing. D and A, you know, you pick up where your battleship is. When you're playing Hangman, you say it's a seven-letter word and it's a fruit. And so somebody has to say it's pineapple or coconut or whatever. And they have to guess the letters. And if they guess enough letters, you've drawn a man hanging from a rope and you win because you've hanged the man. So that was one idea for a show. That was Wheel of Fortune. The next idea is with this other wife. She gets the idea for Wheel of Fortune, where you give somebody the answer and they have to think of the question. And that's called Jeopardy. His wife's name at the time was Julann, J-U-L-A-N-N. She came up with the show's idea on a flight from Minnesota to New York. When the plane landed, she told Merv the idea for the flight. He went right to NBC Network, where the executives bought the show on the spot without a script or a pilot. He just said, great idea. So suddenly he goes in and he does Wheel of Fortune and Jeopardy, and he still owns that time 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock every night for all time. We all know Jeopardy had the host, Alex Trebek, who recently passed away, and Alex had a great 40 or 50 years on that. Way back when I did Music Off and Let Us Go on CBC in 67, 68, Alex Trebek was a host from the Toronto show for one of the seasons. So I had a great affinity and a great love for Alex Trebek and knew him for quite a while. So we're going to give you both the themes to Wheel of Fortune and Jeopardy, written by Merv Griffin and played by the Merv Griffin Orchestra. Created by Merv Griffin, and everybody in the world knows those theme songs. They were just incredible piece of Americana. Now we're moving on to another television show called The Monkees. Because the Beatles had such great success doing their own videos, which were filmed of all cut and sped up motion stuff, somebody had the idea to create an American Beatles, and they were called The Monkees. This is the theme song from The Monkees, written by Tommy Boyce and Bobby Hart, who wrote a lot of hit songs. I like Last Train to Clarksville and things like that. Anyways, here's the theme for The Monkees. Played basically by the Wrecking Crew, because the guy, Monkees couldn't play their own instruments to this proficiency yet. So it's, you know, the Wrecking Crew, who was the LA session musicians, but the Monkees are singing it. Here they are, 1967. Hey, hey, we're the Monkees.
Here we come.
Where to?
theme, and now getting back to Canada to a theme that was on the air for over 35 years and spanned more than 500 episodes. We're talking about the most successful example of television franchising in Canadian history, Degrassi High, Degrassi Junior High. Amazing. My lawyer Stephen Stone and his wife created that show. Then the show became so successful and so busy, he retired from his firm. He still owned the firm, but he spent all his time doing international contracts for hundreds of countries that wanted to run this show, and for clearing all the music, and gave a great breakthrough to Canadian songwriters and actors, and gave everybody their start as a teenager, the most notable being Drake, who was the main actor on Degrassi, and he then went on to become Drake. Okay, we all know Drake. So here we go with Degrassi Junior High theme, 1979. Of all time, Sesame Street, Sunny Day, Chasing the Cloud, directly to tell me how to get to Sesame Street. It was on PBS all over the States and on CBC in Canada. It has run 50 seasons over five rockin' decades. This is from a live performance of Gladys Knight, who were on Sesame Street. A lot of people were on. Person with me. I'll give you a hint.